The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, William died with Christ and rose with him to eternal life. May he now share with him eternal glory. We gather together this morning in this wonderful worship space of St. Patrick Church that was so dear to Bill, to his family, and to many of us who are here today. And as we prepare to celebrate this wonderful gift that God has given us, the gift of the Holy Mass in remembrance of Bill, before we begin that prayer, we would like to have a couple of remarks with Anthony. So if you please be seated at this moment, Anthony will come forward and offer a few remarks, followed by his good friend Bill.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you all so much for being here today. It means a lot to us, and it means a lot to Nono. I want to say thank you from my mom, who we refer to lovingly as Mother Teresa. From my brothers and sisters, Aunt Colleen. Where are you, Aunt Colleen? There you are, front row. Uncle Sean, who will be here by the grace of God. Uncle Derek, there he is. And brother, cousin Andre. Last but not least, I want to thank you from Bill and Teresa's 12 grandchildren, who are all here today. And I wondered if we could get the 12 grandchildren just to stand up quickly, because I've never seen you dress this nicely. And it's absolutely beautiful. Mom, Mary, this is a photo opportunity a little bit later. Nono would be proud. So, you know, there's a tradition of dressing up for funerals and wearing a tie. It's something I don't get to do much anymore. And I was thinking as I put on my tie this morning, am I doing this for Bill or am I doing this for something else? And I realized, Bill wouldn't really care. He's just happy I'm here. Mm-hmm. So I put on this tie for my mother, Ma Mère, who has been Bill's faithful and constant companion for over 60 years. And in this last 4 months, she has shown that love and support for Bill like no other, constantly by his side, constantly feeding him, sometimes to excess, constantly caring for him, talking to him, even when he stopped talking, she was there for Bill, and when he died, she was kneeling by his side. So, Ma Mère, I'm wearing this tie for you, because I know it's important to you. And Bill, I wore the airplane tie, so you know I'm thinking about you. We're actually having two funeral masses for Bill. One is today, and one will be next Friday, a much smaller group of family up on Vashon Island, Washington, where Bill will be buried. And one day, Mother Teresa will be buried right next to him. And in her infinite wisdom, Aunt Teresa, or Mother Teresa, planned two masses, I think, because she believes that a mass will guarantee Bill a spot in heaven. And maybe by having a second mass, who knows, maybe they can get a suite upstairs. And that would be nice. But I yesterday spoke with an Irishman who knows a lot about this sort of thing. And he said to me, "Oh, Anthony, don't you worry about that. Bill's already in. You see, in 441 AD, St. Patrick walked up on a hill in Ireland, and he spent 40 days and 40 nights fasting. And up there, he argued with God, and he negotiated with God. And actually, he negotiated a side door for the Irish. So Bill doesn't have to see St. Peter. He'll go right in with St. Patrick." He told me, "To this day, the last Sunday of July, there are Irish that climb this same mountain in bare feet to celebrate what St. Patrick did for all the Irishmen. And St. Patrick, we're grateful for that." So today is a celebration of Bill's life. We are first going to celebrate with a Mass. And this will be a traditional Catholic Mass, and many Burkes will play a key role in it. And then after that, we will be going just down the street, walking just a few doors down to Don Antonio's, where we'll be having lunch outside, and we will be able to celebrate in a fashion that Bill would be quite proud of. We can toast, if you'd like, you can roast, you can sing songs, you can read poems, whatever you'd like to do. So with that, I'd like to say once again, thank you for being here, and I would like to invite Milt Gaines up to say just another quick words. Milt Gaines, our Uncle Milty as we know him, is one of Bill's oldest friends. They went to Yale together. They were both ROTC, Navy ROTC at Yale. They were in the Blue Tail Fly Squadron at Moffett Field, where they flew A4 Skyhawks. And Uncle Milty and his family has been an absolute critical part of all of our lives since I was born. So Uncle Milty, thank you so much for being here and for saying a few words.
I'm Uncle Milty to the Burke family, bro to my dearest, closest friend, Bill. 68 years ago, we met as freshmen in college, spent 4 years plus in naval aviation, ultimately flying in the same squadron in WestPac, followed by 60 years in the Bay Area as our families grew. Through all of these years, I never once witnessed Bill wavering from the teachings of his faith. He lived each day of each week, of each month, of each year, according to what he had learned in his Catholic upbringing. With the ironclad strength of will inherited from his mother, and the firm but gentle love from his father, he was able to see the best in everyone he met. He developed new friendships without expectation. He forgave his mistakes without our mistakes, without judgment. He had the sincerest compassion for others of anyone I've ever known. He was my mentor for how best to live in this earth school. I never knew Bill to shy away from dangerous situations. He just exercised proper precaution. Perhaps then it is only fitting that this funeral mass be conducted today, in spite of our COVID fears, to honor Bill's life.
Please stand. As was mentioned in remarks, we are here really to celebrate, the life of a great man, but more importantly, to celebrate what God has done for Bill now, as he has welcomed him, we pray and we hope, into eternal life forever and ever. And so we begin with our prayer. Let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life, so as to open up an entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant Bill be inscribed in the book of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated now for our first reading from Sacred Scripture.
I'd like to preface this reading with a sweet memory from a couple of weeks ago. It was just a few days before my father was no longer able to converse, and I arrived at my parents' home in the morning to find my mother sitting tightly knit next to my father in his hospital bed in the living room, and they were singing old Pete Seeger songs together. And one of them was written based exactly on this reading, Turn, Turn, Turn. Ecclesiastes chapter 3. There is a season for everything, a time for every occupation under heaven, a time for giving birth, a time for dying, a time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted, a time for killing, a time for healing, a time for knocking down, a time for building, a time for tears, a time for laughter, a time for mourning, a time for dancing, a time for throwing stones away, a time for gathering them, a time for embracing, a time to refrain from embracing, a time for searching, a time for losing, a time for keeping, a time for discarding, a time for tearing, a time for sowing, a time for keeping silent, a time for speaking, a time for loving, a time for hating, a time for war, a time for peace.
You spread the table before. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the book of Philippians. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say, rejoice. Let all men know your forbearance. The Lord is at hand. Have no anxiety about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. What you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, do, and the God of peace will be with you. In the name of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. We do not know the way. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Well, the day has arrived. And no, I'm not referring to the 23rd of October and the funeral mass we are now celebrating. I'm referring to the day that Bill had been looking forward to for some time. The day that he would meet his God, our God, and be welcomed into paradise. Yes, that day has arrived. And today, the 23rd of October, we gather in this holy place, this worship space that Bill and many of you have come to love. And it was here for many, many years that Bill had the good fortune of encountering the living God through word and sacrament. It is here that Bill deepened his relationship with the Lord and with many of you. His love for our parish and the adult choir. And as an aside, he's probably already joined the celestial choir. And I notice over here, you may notice there's a little empty stool there. That's where he sat for quite a long time as he joined in our choir to augment our worship on Sunday mornings at 10 o'clock. Rightfully so, that should be engraved on there, Bill's stool. Yes, his love for his parish, but he also had love for little ones he would see after Mass on the front plaza as they would banter about. And he also loved the chatter and the banter of his fellow parishioners, engaging them in conversation. You know, what Bill encountered here carried over and enriched his daily life. He realized and so appreciated his many blessings. He was blessed richly with a loving family, his wife Teresa, his children Anthony, Colleen, Sean, Derek, Andre, and his 12 grandchildren. He was blessed with an appreciation for good food, fine wines, art, literature, especially poetry, and nature. Yes, Bill was richly blessed, and I'm convinced many of his blessings were a result of his great faith in God. The second reading, which we heard read by Derek this morning, I hope you're a lector, whatever church you belong to. You did a great job reading that. You know, you read it with such fervor and the way Scripture should be proclaimed. But in that beautiful reading from St. Paul, talking to the church in the Philippians, he said, "Rejoice in the Lord always." I hope you caught that. How could you not catch it? I say it again, rejoice in the Lord always. The Lord is near. Dismiss all anxiety from your minds and present your needs to God in petitions full of gratitude. I really believe this is how Bill lived and understood his life in the world, with rich and abiding faith and gratitude. All of you know the past couple of years have not been easy for Bill, especially the last 4 months. Nevertheless, relying on God, he remained faithful, knowing what ultimately awaited him. Yes, I believe that Bill's kindness stemmed from what we are doing here and now, expressing our gratitude and thanking God with the greatest prayer we have to offer, the prayer of the Holy Mass. Yes, it is with gratitude that we gather to thank God for the many blessings he has bestowed on us in this life and the offer to those who follow his Son, the gift of eternal life in a place not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Recall what Jesus said to his disciples in the Gospel today. He said, "I am going to prepare a place for you, and I will come back and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be." And of course, the disciple piped up and said, "Well, we don't know where you're going." They didn't understand this yet. How can we know the way? And Jesus told them, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." Bill knew the way, and he knew that Jesus would come again and take him to himself. And Jesus did just that on October 14th. When I first moved to St. Patrick about 4.5 years ago, Bill and Teresa were one of the first to invite me to their home for dinner. I think they wanted to get the scoop on who this new priest was. It was a delightful evening, which I remember clearly and fondly. We gathered in the living room for drinks prior to dinner, and we had a lovely conversation learning about one another. Moving on to dinner, the conversation continued, and so did the wine, which, by the way, made us feel very merry, for of course they were serving Mary Edward wine. As the dinner and conversation unfolded, and as we moved to the end of the meal, not knowing Bill's love for poetry, he asked, "Would you like to hear a poem or two?" I, of course, said yes. And an hour and a half later, I was still listening to poetry and stories being regaled by Bill. What I found so moving was his incredible love of the world around him and all that goes on in it. He was a thinker, someone who took things in, pondered them, and realized with a profound faith that all was a gift from his creator, the living God. Over the past month or so, I had the pleasure of twice visiting with Bill, having lunch and celebrating with him the sacraments of the church. On one of those visits, he received three sacraments, and I told him afterwards he was full of it, full of grace, that is. We laughed a little, but he knew, too, that it was true. He was getting ready. In fact, he was ready to meet his Creator, and he knew it would not be long. My last visit with Bill was just 2 weeks ago. Once again, we talked and enjoyed a lovely lunch together in the backyard. At one point, before you arrived, Colleen, actually, at one point when he and I were alone in the yard, he opined, "It won't be long now." And I responded, "Yes, Bill, it is true. It won't be long now." It was a visit I will never forget. He knew and he wasn't afraid. In fact, I believe that as much as he loved his family and life in this world, he truly believed that what awaited him was Jesus. And he was indeed the Jesus that we hear about in the gospel today. It was true. He was going to his new home, the place he was destined to inherit from the beginning. His journey was almost complete, and now it is so. He is home, and for Bill, day is done. Teresa, Anthony, Colleen, Sean, Derek, Andre, you were all so very fortunate to have had such rich and memorable times with Bill these past many months. That time was truly a gift from God, and hopefully each of you are filled with gratitude for what God has done for him and for each of you who believe. For our day too is coming. There is nothing to be feared, but something to be looked for in the context of our faith. You see this paschal candle at the foot of the coffin. That symbol, that candle, is brought out twice in a person's life. It's brought out at baptism and again at a person's funeral. It symbolizes Christ, the light of the world. It is blessed at the Easter vigil and reminds us that Christ has dispelled the darkness of sin and death once and for all. It reminds us that Christ, the light of the world, leads us to eternal life where there is no more sadness, no more tears, no more pain, only happiness and joy. Today we celebrate what God has done for Bill both in this life and now in eternal life. Let us give thanks, rejoice, and be glad for Bill. For indeed his day is done, and the bright promise of immortality made to him at his baptism has dawned. Indeed, let us thank the Lord. Amen. Please stand. At this time, we now offer our prayers of faith and petitions to the Lord, who is always attentive to our pleadings.
At this, the appointed time, God has taken Bill by the hand and brought him to the beautiful place he prepared for him. As we contemplate the great joy Bill now knows, let our hearts not be troubled. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bill has always known the way he was going. That we, like him, turn always to Christ as the way, the truth, and the life. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bill delighted in a world of charge, a world charged with the grandeur of God, that we, like him, guided by the Holy Spirit, may grow to see and enjoy the dearest, freshness, deep down things, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gratitude continuously flowed from Bill. May we all be increasingly thankful for all our blessings. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That like Bill, we may grow as faithful friends, providing sturdy shelter and healing to all we encounter. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In Bill, we all knew the steady, kind, and humor-filled love of God. That we may love more deeply and always use the gifts God has given us to serve others. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the deceased families and friends of all present this morning, and most particularly Bill's parents, Anthony and Jean Donaher, Grandma Burke, and his brothers and sisters, Gertrude Walsh, Patricia Murphy, Edwin Burke, Maureen Burke, my own mother, that they may have eternal rest. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for hearing these prayers and those that remain silent within our hearts. We know you are always attentive to our needs, and we thank you for being our God, leading us gently but ever faithfully to you, where you live with your risen Son Jesus and the Holy Spirit, reigning in heaven as one God forever and ever. Amen.
Grace. Father went down to the river to pray. Father went down to the river to pray. To pray. To the river to
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Bill, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin clung to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of death might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Patrick, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Salvatore Corleone, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Bill, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. who are prepared and Catholic may come forward now for Holy Communion.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Bill, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Come and find the place where I am lost.
stand. A great testimony to Bill, of course, from Willa. It was a wonderful job there at singing Danny Boy, and I know the Irish is very strong in his family and that type of thing. And I must say that I'm a little touched by that as well, with the name Opatazinski. Actually, I am 50% Irish. My mother's 100% Irish, and so I really identify with that. And I always enjoyed Bill's humor and his wonderful way of just appreciating life, like so many of the Irish do. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. And may our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. I will now reverently incense the mortal remains of Bill that housed the immortal soul for 86 years. And as this incense rises to the heavens, so may it take with it our prayers for him and ourselves. Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our brother Bill in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Bill in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Oh, we dwell in the shelter of the Lord.
Thank you.